Hi, I'm Chris Katulka with the Friends of Israel Gospel Ministry, and before we get to this week's Eye on the Middle East, I'd like to share an urgent need with you. As you may know, I host the Friends of Israel Today radio program, and every week we have the privilege of providing listeners with biblical content on the air and through our podcast. But what you may not know is that our program is supported by generous donors and listeners and friends just like you. Through the month of November, we need your help. Can you help us raise $25,000 this month to take the gospel to the ends of the earth? The world is desperate for biblical truth about Israel and the Messiah. So with your financial gift, right now, you can help keep the Friends of Israel Today's trustworthy, uncompromising biblical teaching in the ears and hearts of those who need to hear. Would you make a gift before November ends? Go to foi.org/radio support to make your meaningful gift today. Hi, I'm Chris Katulka with the Friends of Israel Gospel Ministry, and this is an Eye on the Middle East. Iran's supreme leader warned of a crushing response to recent Israeli strikes on Iran's territory as the Pentagon announced plans to deploy additional resources to the region over the coming months. Initially, Tehran minimized the impact of last month's Israeli strikes, hinting at a possible de-escalation. However, in recent days, Iran's supreme leader, Ayatollah Khamenei, adopted a more aggressive stance, signaling a shift from restraint toward potential retaliation. Khamenei has the authority as supreme leader to order strikes on Israel. In a statement posted online, he said on Saturday that Israel and the United States would definitely receive a tooth-breaking response for actions against Iran. Khamenei's statements align with recent comments from General Ali Fadavi, deputy commander of the Islamic Revolutionary Guard. He stated that Iran's response to the Zionist aggression is definite, emphasizing the nation's capability to destroy all that the Zionists possess with one operation. Well, here's my take. I'd like to remind Iranian leadership of what God told Abraham in Genesis 12:3. Do you remember? He said, "I will bless those who bless you and curse those who curse you." Iran, you should be careful how you respond to Israel, because as history has shown, God will curse those who curse his chosen people. You might want to get on the side of blessing today.